playing into those microphones and we did not do a sound check. So that's what we're doing right now. Just dialing in the sounds of the bamboo flute. This is a real great place to be, playing the bamboo flute. Playing for my fellow woodwind or creative music colleagues, they don't really always understand the extent to which bamboo has actually infected my psyche. But I think everyone here can relate to that a little bit more. I was a professional clarinetist and saxophone player and started playing shakuhachi as a hobby. Shakuhachi comes from Japan and has a long history in Zen Buddhism. As a solo breath meditation instrument. So it's equal parts spiritual cultivation and artistic expression. And a lot of people actually fill these flutes with lacquer in order to make the sound project more and to tune them. The type of flute that I play is called G-nashi, meaning without G, without lacquer. So the inner bore of these flutes is the bamboo texture that you're all familiar with. It's not lacquer. So that adds a component of complication for the player, but the feeling of texture for the breath is much more rewarding, in my opinion. So because there's so much talking at these events, which it kind of has to be, the reason I wanted to come was to play bamboo and express my ongoing life, really, of finding the soul of bamboo and actually the soul of nature through the simple sound, we could say simple, of this flute. There's only five holes, there's no moving parts, there's no mouthpiece, there's no flipple hole. There's just a chunk taken out of the top of the tube and the notes are removed. So five holes. We can play all of the notes, which I will demonstrate soon. So I'll fill in the gaps by speaking a bit, but I wanted to make sure that I got plenty of playing. So I'm going to play another piece. That piece was the theme from the TV show Kung Fu. It's a good sound check. So how many people recognize Kung Fu? So everything that the flute plays starts sounding like meditation music. We'll see if that holds true when I play Jimi Hendrix in a little bit. But next time I'm going to play a piece of mine called Baby Bear Drinks Tea. And this is based on a dream that my girlfriend had about a baby bear. And besides bamboo, I also own a baby to tea.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I also wanted to come to this event because my album I released this year is called Bamboo Rising. And it's volume 2 of a series I'm releasing called Shakuhachi Unleashed, which of course refers to the fact that there's actually a lot of possibilities with this instrument. I honor and have learned in the Zen Buddhist tradition, and the song tattooed on my arm is a piece from the Zen Buddhist tradition, but on the other arm there's redwoods and bamboo and swamp thing and mushrooms. So it doesn't stay in one place. I think that possibilities and bamboo go together very well. And on the next album, which is going to be finished this year, I've got a couple of Jimi Hendrix students. And because you're all waiting around and putting off your dinners and listen to me play these magic whistles, I'm going to play some Jimi Hendrix for you on the shotgun. Thank you very much. That was Hey Joe. Not a song he wrote, but it was his first hit. And it's important to stay hydrated when you're playing the bamboo. And when I got my first shakuhachi, I was concerned about it getting wet, like my clarinets. And of course, the maker said, well, bamboo loves water. So now we're going to play original piece of mine where I transitioned to the bigger size flute. However, the bamboo grows, monks have been playing flutes of that size. So this is the standard size now, in a way, but the big flute is kind of a favorite of mine, and I have ones that go a little lower than the one I have with me. So this is about soprano size, and the one I'm going to switch to in the middle of this piece is about, I would consider, baritone size. It's not that much lower, but there's no keys. So there's a limit to how far your fingers can stretch. This piece is called Hymn to the She Dragon of the Deep. Thank you. onto the big flute, I feel a responsibility to make sure we fit in an official meditation piece from the repertoire. Don't worry, it's a 4-minute one, not a 10-minute one. So you can meditate a little bit. This is a breath-centric meditation. It contains all the basic phrases that the pieces include to get more complicated. It's called Om Sharabe, meaning the original song or inner piece, inner song. And unlike the other pieces I'm playing, where I'm doing a bit of circular breathing, that's not permitted in these songs because everything is gauged on the breath. There's no rhythm per se, but there is pacing based on the breath and the room and the flute. So this is Om Sharabe. actually goes back to the small flute, and it's another original piece of mine. It's called Green Swampy Water. So I have a lot of nature-related pieces, because in the Buddhist repertoire, that's kind of how things break down. They're either Buddhist metaphysics titles, like Ajikan, like A, the first letter of the Sanskrit alphabet, Buddhist concepts, or nature titles, like waterfall, or falling leaves, or distant cry of a deer, things like this. So not only have I written original pieces inspired by specific locations in nature, but also I have arranged pieces from classic rock and metal that have nature titles, like Freebird. I have an arrangement of Freebird. I'm not going to play it today unless you really demand it, but Run to the Hills is a piece by Iron Maiden, and I am going to close with that after Green Swampy Water. So Green Swampy Water, and then Iron Maiden's Run to the Hills, and then if there's a significant demand for something else, I'll either play it or have some Q&A, and also make sure you find me afterwards if you want an album and get on my mailing list. So thank you so much. Two more songs. This is going to be obvious, but Green Swampy Water is actually a blues.
Thank you.
Have a great rest of the week. Thanks very much.